This is Rhonda Brooks of Farm Journal Media, and I'm here today at a GrowMark FS meeting, and I'm speaking to Dean Collamer, who's a field sales agronomist with a company in the Northeast. And Dean, we've been talking about nutrient use efficiency and how that can, thinking about that and managing for that can help growers go into the 2013 season. And I wanted to see if you could just give us some tips or some applications.
Sure. Nutrient use efficiency is a topic that I really focus quite a bit of my field work on and my grower presentations on because it's consistent with a 4R strategy of nutrient management, using nutrients properly with best management practices. And what I'm talking about is using source, rate, timing, and placement of nutrients so they stay where you want them, give us good yield, and give us a high degree of yield per unit of fertilizer applied.
Okay, and we're speaking corn specifically.
Yes, this really pertains to all crops, but certainly because of the high nutrient usage by corn, it's most apropos to talk about corn as probably the dominant crop in the discussion.
Okay, so you said source was the first one?
Sure.
Give me a for instance. How would I put that?
Yeah. Some of your sources that you need to consider in using nutrients is the soil itself, because the soil itself provides some of the nutrients. And as well, you need to consider nutrients from animal manures and then nutrients from commercial fertilizers that are applied. And you need to know what those sources are, understand when and their efficiency, and do the corresponding rates that are associated with that that application so that you put the total amount that the crop is needing to achieve the yields that you're shooting for.
Okay, and let's go on down the line. So what's the next one?
Yeah, placement. Let's look at placement. You have lots of options on placement. Sometimes you can place fertilizer where you need it in an ideal fashion, and sometimes you can't. Let's look at no-till versus conventional. One of the limitations on no-till, of course, is that it's difficult to incorporate many times depending on your situation and how you're trying to preserve or not preserve your crop residue. So placement is very important consideration. Another good example on placement is the use of starters or pop-ups, which is a band kind of application as opposed to a broadcast where you're trying to isolate those nutrients close to the seed, close to the emerging young plant to try to improve the nutrient uptake with that very strategically placed application.
And that seems to be something increasingly people are looking at. And I heard Missy Bauer, our associate field agronomist, speak to this as far as nitrogen usage, that there are a variety of timings and ways to get that product better used by the corn plant.
Right.
Yeah. Is there anything here in the Northeast that you're seeing farmers do that in that arena that they could improve upon, you know, that some recommendations you'd make?
Sure. With nitrogen and nitrogen use efficiency and trying to improve it is to put the nitrogen in a place where it's available when the plant wants to see it. So you can do it by repeat application. Another way to do it would be to use a rate that corresponds to that crop need at that time. A new emerging technology is using NDVI technique to measure the crop need using that reflectance of green light off the crop and vary your nitrogen rate on the fly. Another way to do that and make nitrogen available when the crop needs it is to use nitrogen stabilizers. And a lot of my field research involves the evaluation of different nitrogen stabilizers, either with combination with manure or in combination with commercial fertilizers.
Are those... I think that's really interesting. Here in the Northeast, are those nitrogen stabilizers used a great deal or not?
Yes, they're used quite a bit, and we find quite a bit of growth inside GrowMark FS in their utilization. And there's a number of different nitrogen stabilizers with different modes of action. that determines which nitrogen stabilizer you should use depending on the situation and your goals of your nitrogen application.
Could you give me a couple examples on that?
Sure. If you broadcast urea, for example, there are three or four nitrogen stabilizers that are more suited to that application. If you use anhydrous ammonia that's injected, you use a different nitrogen stabilizer. And some of the nitrogen stabilizers are appropriate for use with animal manures, some of them not. And so with manure application, you can use nitrogen stabilizers also.
Okay. Well, Dean, I appreciate you talking to me. Any last, comments that you'd want to make to a farmer audience about what you've got going on?
Sure. Looking ahead to 2013 and the crop year ahead, I think there are several of these nitrogen use efficiency technologies that you should consider. My work has shown that there's an advantage to using them, and certainly you should explore the opportunity to use some of those products and practices to help improve nutrient use efficiency.
All right. Well, Dean, thank you for your time.
All right. Thank you, Rhonda.
This is Rhonda Brooks of Farm Journal Media, and I'm here today at a GrowMark FS meeting, and I'm speaking to Dean Collamer, who's a field sales agronomist with a company in the Northeast. And Dean, we've been talking about nutrient use efficiency and thinking about that and managing for that can help growers go into the 2013 season. And I wanted to see if you could just give us some tips or some applications.
Sure. Nutrient use efficiency is a topic that I really focus quite a bit of my field work on and my grower presentations on because it's consistent with a 4R strategy of nutrient management, using nutrients properly with best management practices. And what I'm talking about is using source, rate, timing, and placement of nutrients so they stay where you want them, give us good yield, and give us a high degree of yield per unit of fertilizer applied.
Okay, and we're speaking corn specifically.
Yes, this really pertains to all crops, but certainly because of the high nutrient usage by corn, it's most apropos to talk about corn as probably the dominant crop in the discussion.
Okay, so you said source was the first one?
Sure.
Give me a for instance. How would I put that?
Yeah. Yeah, some of your sources that you need to consider in using nutrients is the soil itself, because the soil itself provides some of the nutrients. And as well, you need to consider nutrients from animal manures and then nutrients from commercial fertilizers that are applied. And you need to know what those sources are, understand when and their efficiency, and do the corresponding rates that are associated with that that application so that you put the total amount that the crop is needing to achieve the yields that you're shooting for.
Okay. And let's go on down the line. So what's the next one?
Yeah, placement. Let's look at placement. You have lots of options on placement. Sometimes you can place fertilizer where you need it in an ideal fashion, and sometimes you can't. Let's look at no-till versus conventional. One of the limitations on no-till, of course, is that it's difficult to incorporate many times depending on your situation and how you're trying to preserve or not preserve your crop residue. So placement is very important consideration. Another good example on placement is the use of starters or pop-ups, which is a band kind of application as opposed to a broadcast where you're trying to isolate those nutrients close to the seed, close to the emerging young plant to try to improve the nutrient uptake with that very strategically placed application.
And that seems to be something increasingly people are looking at. And I heard Missy Bauer, our associate field agronomist, speak to this as far as nitrogen usage, that there are a variety of timings and ways to get that product better used by the corn plant.
Right, right.
Yeah. Is there anything here in the Northeast that you're seeing farmers do that in that arena that they could improve upon? You know, that some recommendations you'd make?
Sure. With nitrogen and nitrogen use efficiency and trying to improve it is to put the nitrogen in a place where it's available when the plant wants to see it. So you can do it by repeat application. Another way to do it would be to use a rate that corresponds to that crop need at that time. A new emerging technology is using NDVI technique to measure the crop need using that reflectance of green light off the crop and vary your nitrogen rate on the fly. Another way to do that and make nitrogen available when the crop needs it is to use nitrogen stabilizers. And a lot of my field research involves the evaluation of different nitrogen stabilizers, either with combination with manure or in combination with commercial fertilizers.
Are those... I think that's really interesting. Here in the Northeast, are those nitrogen stabilizers used a great deal or not?
Yes, they're used quite a bit, and we find quite a bit of growth inside GrowMark FS in their utilization. And there's a number of different nitrogen stabilizers with different modes of action that kind of determines which nitrogen stabilizer you should use depending on the situation and your goals of your nitrogen application.
Could you give me a couple examples on that?
Sure. If you broadcast urea, for example, there are three or four nitrogen stabilizers that are more suited to that application. If you use anhydrous ammonia that's injected, you use a different nitrogen stabilizer. And some of the nitrogen stabilizers are appropriate for use with animal manures, some of them not. And so with manure application, you can use nitrogen stabilizers also.
Okay. Well, Dean, I appreciate you talking to me. Any last, you know, comments that you'd want to make to a farmer audience about what you've got going on?
Sure. Looking ahead to 2013 and the crop year ahead, I think there are several of these nitrogen use efficiency technologies that you should consider. My work has shown that there's an advantage to using them, and certainly you should explore the opportunity to use some of those products and practices to help improve nutrient use efficiency.
All right. Well, Dean, thank you for your time.
All right. Thank you, Rhonda.